Last week, we spoke about seventh commandment of God, which is, "Thou shalt not commit adultery." It was not easy for me to preach that, but God wanted all of us to know His mind. Last week, the Word of God showed us that sex triggers adultery. Sex triggers adultery, and adultery is sexual immorality. Pastor, totoo ba yun? Talagang sex triggers immorality? Yung mga may asawa, would you get somebody who is more, who is na lesser than your, more, will you get somebody who is not more beautiful than your wife? Amen? When you look at somebody, right? You're first attracted to their appearance. Sex triggers adultery, and adultery is sexual immorality. It is a sexual sin. Besides what we knew about adultery, having a relationship with a married person, there are several types of adultery that we have spoken about. One is fornication. Fornication, which is sex outside of marriage. It is not love, but an illusion of love when we disrespect each other's body. Fornication is a disrespect for each other's body. In 1 Corinthians 6:18-20, exhorts us that our body is the temple of the living God, of the Holy Spirit. Another form of adultery is in the area of pornography and masturbation. See, Jesus Christ Himself said, "You have heard that it was said, 'You shall not commit adultery.' But I tell you that anyone who looks at a woman lustfully has already committed adultery with her in his heart." Another form of adultery is prostitution. This is the age-old sin wherein one uses his own body to solicit money. It is a social ill that causes men and women to sin. It is a lack of faith that God can provide for your needs. And finally, homosexuality. Homosexuality is a lie of Satan. He is the father of lies, John 8:44. He made the victims to believe that there are persons who were born as such. Nobody is born a homosexual. Homosexuality is an alteration of the body chemicals. It's just an alteration of our body chemicals caused about by humanity's perversion. Amen? Incest. Pregnancy outside the womb. These are things, no? Alters the normal course of a body, the normal DNA of a body. Today we're going to talk about the next commandment. You know, when I started our series on the Ten Commandments, I thought that it would be a walk in the park. I thought it was easy to preach this. But I was wrong. I was so wrong. I found out that every command will be such a struggle for me to preach. The insights that was set forth before me was such nerve-wracking that I was tempted to edit my notes because I feared that many will be offended. I was really tempted to edit it and erase those words that will probably offend somebody. But the Lord rebuked me as He reminded me of the warning that the Apostle Paul exhorted Timothy to be aware of. God rebuked me. He said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 2 to 4. My slide, please. It says there, preach the word. Be prepared in season and out of season. Correct, rebuke, and encourage with great patience and careful instruction. For the time will come when people will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myths. God rebuked me. And I needed to heed. I needed to take heed. It is God whom I wanted to please rather than man. Remember this, my friends. If you are offended by God's word that I share to you, it is not my purpose to do so. Because the word of God is a double-edged sword. Amen? It pierces the heart, even the bone marrows. Masakit talaga. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, hindi mo kayang umilag. Hindi mo kayang umilag sa salita ng Diyos. But I share this to you with love. So that we may walk like Jesus walked. In all purity, in all holiness. Today, we shall dwell on the 8th commandment of God. Exodus chapter 20, verse 15. Thou shalt not steal. I have entitled it, Treasures from God. Exodus chapter 20, verse 15. Thou shalt not steal. You know, there's so many stories in the Bible that tells about men stealing from men stealing from God. And I chose this story about Joshua. You see, when Moses died, he anointed Joshua to lead Israel. Now God gave the fortified city of Jericho upon the hands of the Israelites. It was a spectacular display of God's awesome power. Indeed, it is not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Jericho is a fortified city. Nobody can attack it. Now God said to Joshua, I have given you this city. You know, if you trust God, you will not ask God, Lord, are you sure? If God tells you to do something, sasabihin mo sa, especially if it is seemingly an impossible task, sasabihin mo ba sa Panginoon, we, hindi nga. Bibigyan mo talaga sa akin yan. So, but if you have this great faith in God, then Joshua knows it. You know, I love what Sister Tintin said kanina. You know, mark down your spiritual markers. Do not forget your spiritual markers. One of your spiritual markers is when you have received such a miracle from God that not even you can imagine can happen. Amen? But with all of this awesome favor, you know what? Even the task was not to attack with cannons and with arrows and with spears. God gave Joshua this command. He says, you see, for 6 days, you walk around the castle. You walk around around Jericho. Joshua, he says, what? He did not. He prepared the priests, he prepared the trumpets, he prepared the army, and they marched around Jericho. By the way, hindi po malapit na ikutan yon. You see, a whole city. It will take them a long time to finish one round in that city, but they obeyed. Amen? Probably the soldier said, I would rather walk than be shot by an arrow. Amen? And you know, it was probably people would, those soldiers probably would ask, is Joshua crazy? He's really God's leader for me. Probably what some of you hear when I speak, probably you think like, is what pastor say is saying, is it true? But the leader obeyed. For 6 days, one round. And God said, on the seventh day, you will go around Jericho 7 times. Probably first time, second time, third time. Siguro pag fourth ikot na nila yan, no? Fourth time, probably the soldiers were saying, well, I'm so tired, you know, before, let's just attack it. We see the leadership of Joshua remained. He was really believing in God. But the last command was this. It says, it's not attack, no. He said, after the seventh turn, shout. And they shouted. And the most amazing thing happened. The walls of Jericho crumbled. Amen. You cannot imagine what God can do for you. You cannot imagine what God can do. Even in seemingly impossible situations. I know some of you here have experienced the power of God. Amen? The power of God. You know, God's blessing is always ready to be poured out to His children. Amen? God's blessing is ready to be poured out to His children. But we, as His children, need to have faith in Him. Amen? Some people, you know, there are those who wants to hear only preachings on blessing. But blessing cannot come unless you obey God's command. Are you with me? Sabi mga sa katabi mo, okay ka ba? Are you okay? All right. And then while they were, you know, God is giving instruction, God gave a command to Joshua. And he relayed this to his people. The command was this. Next slide, please. He says in Joshua 6:18-19, but keep away from the devoted things so that you will not bring about your own destruction by taking any of them. Otherwise, you will make the camp of Israel liable to destruction and bring trouble on it. All the silver and gold and the articles of bronze and iron are sacred to the Lord. It is sacred to the Lord and must go into His treasury. That was. You see, He's going to create this wonderful miracle. Isa lang. Isa lang ang inihingi niya. You know? Do not be tempted to take these treasures. But Israelite, and then the Israelites saw the amazing miracle of God. But the response of Israel to that command is this. Next slide, please. He says, next slide. He says, just Joshua 7:11-12. You see, after they have conquered Jericho, there's another task. And the task is to conquer the city called Ain. Sino ba si Ain dito? Ain. It's a small city. In fact, when Joshua asked the spies to go and see, take a look, Joshua said, you don't need your whole army. You know, just send them a couple, 3,000 is okay. Because this army is small. We can easily capture this city. But what happened was this, that small city with a small army, pinatakbo nila ang Israel. 36 Israelites were killed, and they, you know, the Israelites scampered for their lives. And then Joshua said, Lord, what happened, Lord? What happened? You see, my friends, probably you have experienced a great miracle from the Lord. Amen. And then as time went by, you really had faith in God. And then there is something, another problem comes your way. Another problem comes your way. And something happened with that problem. It became bigger. It was multiplied. More problems came. And what will you do what will you say? God, are you real? Why are you doing this to me? But Joshua did not do that. He says, Lord, what happened, Lord? Tell me what happened. And then Joshua cried out. He tore off his robes. Sat down, knelt down, tore off his clothes. And what happened? You know what God says? Anong ginagawa mo dyan? What are you doing there, Joshua? He said, Israel has sinned. They have violated my covenant, which I commanded them to keep. They have taken some of the devoted things. They have stolen. They have stolen. They have lied. You see, if you sin, one, another sin will follow. Are you with me? They have stolen, they have lied, they have put them with their own possessions. That is why the Israelites cannot stand against their enemies. They turn their backs and run because they have been made liable to destruction. I will not be with you anymore. Wow. I will not be with you anymore unless you destroy whatever among you is devoted to destruction. You see, if in your life you have received an amazing miracle, and as you went through your life, another problem comes, but instead of God solving it, it divided into more problems. Then ask God why. You could have been doing something. You could have been doing something that have hurt the heart of God, or something that have that you have rebelled against a commandment of God. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, kaya mahalaga magbasa ng Biblia. That's why this is the reason why it's important to read your Bible. Amen. And then God said, somebody did. You see, one thing that is also very, very clear in the Bible is this. When you sin, it is not you who will suffer the consequence. The consequence will go down and trickle down to those who love you, whom you love. Amen? People will be affected. And then what happened? Joshua spoke to the Israelites, and then God gave him instructions until Achan came up. Because Joshua is a man of God. You know, there's a reason why some of you do not want to come near me. Why? Why do you want to come near me? You see, because God's, you know, I can see, I don't know, probably because of the many years that I've been ministering. I know those who are in trouble. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, hindi mo pwede itago. You cannot keep that. Amen. It shows in your face. It shows in your eyes. In your body language. You see? But I'd like to tell you this. No? The more difficult even sins that you have committed, come to me. Because God will make things right for you again. Amen? Amen? Now, Achan says, I kept it. You see? He kept it under... Nag-dig pa siya, kept it, and then he started to, he showed them where he kept it. But the sad thing about this story is this. Achan and his family was destroyed. Amen? Achan and his family was destroyed. Brothers and sisters, even before you do something that you know it is not right, think about your family. Are you with me? Because your family will be affected. There is no sin that I know of that your family will not be affected. It will be. They will be affected. Now listen here. All of us are connected with one another. We affect each other. Are you with me? You're connected with your parents, with your children, the next generation, even the generation before you. Affected by Adam's sin. Listen. Because of the sin of Adam, we were affected. That's why in Romans 3:23 says, all have sinned and have fallen short of the glory of God. And humanity was likewise affected by the action of God's only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. That because of what He has done, we all can be saved. We are part of each other. We affect one another. Because of the sin rebellion of Adam, we were all affected. We were all intended to die in hell. But because of what Jesus has done, because of this single act of Jesus Christ, we are now all affected. Our sins are washed away. And we will have the opportunity to enter heaven's gate. So we affect each other. Adam chose to sin. All of us, we all need to personally believe and surrender our life to Jesus. Adam chose, we need to choose. Are you with me? Adam chose to rebel, we need to choose to surrender to Jesus Christ. And how do you surrender to Jesus Christ? It's not by being a Christian, come on. It's not by coming here to church, come on. It's by living, by obeying the commands of Jesus Christ. And you will be blessed. Now, in the story, we see a clear picture of how God regards sin. Sin is rebellion to God's commandments. Sin is rebellion to God's commandments. And one of His commandments, His eighth commandment, is not to steal. Not to steal. Listen. Sabi mga, tapikin mo yung katabi mo. Gising ka pa. Okay. Alam mo kung bakit kayo inaantok? Alam mo kung bakit kayo inaantok? Ha? Nakakaantok ba yung the way I preach to me? Sigaw na nga ako din eh. Di ba? Gusto nyo magtambling-tambling ako dito para hindi kayo antokin. But the thing is, God, the enemy doesn't want you to listen to this. Amen? Kaya ikaw pinuyat kahapon. Kagabi pinuyat ka. Alam mo may worship service. Ano oras ka natulog? Alas dos, alas tres na sa computer. Pa-alarm-alarm pa. Kaya pagdating dito, late din. Ay. Ayaw ng Panginoon na hindi mo mapakinggan ito. Kaya later on, pag alam mong palagi kang natutulog dito, magdala ka ng dalawang toothpick, ha? Lagi mo sa mata mo, oh, you put the toothpick there. So you... Listen, to whom do we steal? God says, thou shall not steal. Now, to whom do we steal? Achan stole, right? When Achan stole, the Israelites were affected. He did not only steal, but he lied. Now, to whom do we steal? We steal from man and God. Sino po dito ka-experience that na manakawan? Have you experienced anybody who was experienced? Come on. Wow, many of us. Many of us, right? Yeah, when I was in Kenya, the first day in Kenya, in a hotel, just a couple of minutes I went down to have my snack. When I went up, everything, all of my equipments, it was stolen. My laptop, my iPad, my mobile phone, my money, everything. Buti iniwan sa akin yung mga damit ko. Everything was stolen. And I felt bad. But I did not say, Lord, why did you allow this? Sometimes God will take away your crutches. Are you with me? He'll take away your crutches. But it is still stealing. But God will take care of those who stole. I was praying that those who stole my stuff will open my laptop and see the preachings there, and then they will be born again. Amen. In the Philippines, you know, when you wear, do not use Samsonite in the Philippines. They will be stolen. You know, I just put it in my van. When I came back, the windows are shattered, and then my Samsonite was taken away. But you know what's inside the Samsonite? It's my Bible. I was praying that, you know, these guys will read my highlights there, and they get born again. You know, whatever the world takes away from you, God can always give it back. Amen. Just like Job. Amen? Just trust Him. Now, to whom do we steal? We steal from man and God. From man, next slide, from when we steal money and anything connected with it, like material possessions. Amen? Anything that you own, material possessions that you own. Money and anything connected with it, like material possessions and natural resources that are God-given to man, like time, ability, justice. How do we steal time? You work from 8 o'clock. Ano ba ang time dito? Pasok 8, no? You go 8 o'clock. 8 to 8:30, you spend retouching. Taking selfie, kung okay yung book mo. No, 8:30 to 9, you go and, you know, take coffee or tea. And then you chat. Somebody who's already working, you chat. Alam mo ba? Ganon. Pag upo mo, unang bubuksan mo Facebook. This is stealing time. Amen po ba? And what else? You know that you steal time when you are late for an appointment. Are you with me? Because you steal time of the person, no? Of who came there earlier or on time. That's stealing. Amen? Sabi mo sa katabi mo, palagi kang, you know, Filipino must no longer be late. Alright? Because, you know, being on time is respect to other people's time. Do not steal the time of the person you are, of the one who have, whom you have agreed to meet. Amen? What else? Natural resources. Ability! You know that you can steal abilities? Anong tawag doon? Anong tawag doon? Pag nang bumili ka, ano, nag-burn ka ng
piracy.
Intellectual
property.
Property rights.
Loyalty.
You know, intellectual property rights. Yung bang magka-cut and paste ka ng salita doon, ng halimbawa, oy, maganda ito. Yeah, maganda ito. You found a blog. You know, when you read a blog, meron namang source yun, tama po ba? And then you cut out, maganda itong lugar na to. Cut this out and then post it and paste it on your FB account. Without even writing there or putting there who spoke that word, those words. Amen? You know, even if I share stories, this, have you noticed I always put there thank you for a name and then who shared. How about justice? Wow. Sometimes, most often than not, justice is stolen from us. Are you with me? Right? So these are the things and that we can steal from man. From God, what do we now steal from God? From God we steal ayun. Next slide, please, anak. From God, we steal His tithes and love offerings. Take note, I did not say we steal our tithes and love offerings. I said we steal His tithes and love offerings. Because the tithe is not ours. Sometimes we think that we already have given if we give the tithes. No. We return the tithes to God. What is the tithes? It's 10% of everything that God has blessed you with. Amen? In Malachi chapter 3, verse 6 to 12, listen to this. This is the word of God. I, the Lord, do not change. So you, the descendants of Jacob, are not destroyed. Ever since the time of your ancestors, you have turned away from my decrees and have not kept them. Return to me, and I will return to you, says the Lord Almighty. But you ask, how are we to return? Will a mere mortal rob God You rob me. But you ask, how are we robbing you? In tithes and offerings. You are under a curse. Your whole nation, because you are robbing me. Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse that there may be food in my house. But listen to this. He said, test me on this. Test me on this. Test me on this. Says the Lord God Almighty. And see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that there will not be enough room to store it. And not only that, he will still even protect his blessings. His eye will prevent pests from devouring your crops, and the vines in your fields will not drop their fruit before it is ripe, says the Lord God Almighty. Then all the nations will call you blessed, for yours will be a delightful land, says the Lord Almighty. Sometimes, you know, that's why you have so many debts. If you ask yourself, did I tithe? Have I returned the tithe to God? Have you noticed, even if blessings pours out to you, Pastor, di ako nagtataita, pero blessed na blessed ako. Pero titignan mo yung blessing na yon, dadaan lang dyan. Wala na. Tama po ba? Dadaan lang siya. Shhh, ang daming pera. Sige, blessing. Shhh. Pero dadaan lang yan. Ah, Pastor, hindi ako. Wise ako eh. Wise ako. Nilalagay ko sa bangko yan, Pas. Nilalagay ko sa bangko. Until finally, later on, you have to withdraw it. Why? Nagkasakit sa pamilya. Nangailangan. God cannot be mocked. We reap what we sow. Amen? Now, in returning the tithes is 10% of our God-given treasures to God. When we return our tithes, God's tithes, we declare to God, this is what we declare. He says, we trust not in treasures, but only in the heart of our everlasting Savior. Wow. And the heart of the everlasting Savior is to take care of you. Amen? To pray in our behalf. To intercede to God the Father. That's why when we pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, trust not. I remember this story told by Jesus Christ. He was walking and then a very rich young man came. And then he says, teacher, how can I enter the kingdom of God? Jesus Christ said, follow all the commandments. And then this rich young man said, but teacher, I have followed every commandment of God since I was small. And Jesus said, okay, sell all of your treasures and give it to the poor. And the rich man turned his back away from God, from Jesus. Why? Because he was so rich, he could not depart from his treasure. And Jesus was sad. Amen? He says, it is more easier for a camel to enter, you know, the eye of a needle. You see, when you tithe, it is not the money that is important. It's not the money. It is your heart. Amen? A heart to trust God. A heart who can say, Lord, this is yours. I give it to you. I do not want to rob you, Lord. It is your heart. Okay. You know, most often than not, Lord, I will tithe. Bakit? Eh, 2,000 ang sweldo ko, di 200. Okay, simple, no? 200. Say, Lord. Aba, na-promote, naging 500, 5,000 sweldo. 5,000 salary. Lord, 500 na to, Lord. And then, tithes. And then, habang nagtatithes ka, you cannot outgive God. Amen? Pero huwag nang gawing business, ha? God, gawin ko na 20%, baka maging 10,000 sweldo ko. Remember, it is your heart that God looks upon. Amen? And then naging 10,000 na. Bless the Lord. Favors flowed in his life. Amen? Favors not only from God, but only from men and women in your workplace. And he has given you the ability to produce wealth. And then you were, you know, the Bible says, will I not open the floodgates of heaven? It blesses you. 10,000 na sweldo ko. 10,000 na yun. Sige. 1,000. Aba, sumubro pa blessing dahil, no? Naging 15,000, naging 20,000.
Wow.
Ang sweldo. Listen this, alam niyo ba, mas kapag hindi ka nagtatayos, mas marami kang pera, mas mabilis ka mawala ng pera. Tama ba? Right? Right? So 20,000 na, Lord, 2,000. Lord, can I talk to you, Lord? You know, I've been giving tithes for a long time. Pwede ba hati na lang tayo? Hindi, Lord, yung kalahati bibigay ko, love offering, promise. Yung iba magsasabi, God, nagpaalam ako kay Pastor. Kasi may church din ako sa Philippines, I also have a church in the Philippines. Nagpaalam ako, hati. Yung 50% ng tithes ko dito sa ACCI, yung kalahati sa church. Ano kaya kung hingan ko kayo ng Western Union? May bibigay nyo kaya? If I ask you, will you please provide a Western Union address to your pastor? Can you give it to me? Sabi mo sa katabi mo, you cannot fool God. In fact, if you obey, even if it's difficult to obey, God can provide, God can give you immeasurably more than you can ever think of or imagine. We wanted to have a renewal of vows. If we do it in the Philippines, probably we will spend 200,000-300,000. Dami kaya kamag-anak. Di ba? Right? We went, God bless us. We went to Canada. Akala ko, Lord, okay to. Baka dito sa Canada. Ano pa naman si Pastor Bong, di ba? And layo ni Pastor Bong, 12 hours and difference. 12 hours trip. So we were not able to do it. So he says, Lord, bahala na, Lord. Baka next year. But next year it'll be 26 years, no? No meaning. And then suddenly, ACCI gave us a memorable renewal of vows. Let's give the Lord a clap of praise. Sometimes you plan, but God's plan is higher than your plans.
Amen.
Amen. Trust the Lord with all of your heart. Now, in giving love offerings, not only tithes, but also love offerings. You see, in giving our love offerings, we show our love for God by supporting the work that He has started through Jesus Christ. By being compassionate, right? What did Jesus Christ did? The salvation of mankind. Pastor, meron namang pledges. Hello? Pastor, may pledges na naman si Pastor. Diba, paano bibigay naman sa atin sa namatayan? Pastor, may pledges na naman kasi. You see? Sabi ng Panginoon, if you have something in your heart, no? And when you give your tithes and love offerings, iwan mo muna. Umayos ka muna. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, umayos ka muna. No, umayos ka muna. We cannot outgive God. Challenge for us today, brethren, is this. God would like to remind us once again. He says, love the Lord your God with all our heart and with all our soul and with all our mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it, love our neighbor as ourselves. Kung titignan natin dito, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind, kasama ang tithes and love offerings. That's trusting Him, amen? Tithes lang pala yon. And then, this is the first and greatest. Second is like it, love your neighbor as you love. We love our Challenge for us today is this. Brethren, do not steal from man. God sees it. Amen? Lalo na dito, ang dami kayang CCTV. Pero kahit makawala ka sa CCTV dito, hindi ka makakawala doon sa CCTV ni God. God sees it. And whatever you do, any rebellion that you do, it is written in the books that will be opened when we enter, when we face the great white throne judgment. It will be there. Amen? Do not steal from God. Return the tithes. 10% of everything. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, kapatid, neto ha, hindi gross. Baka mamaya, tinanggal mo na muna lahat yung gastos mo. Tapos kung nung naiwan, yung napinag-tides mo. Kinumputan mo ng tides. You know, I tell you, my friends, God's word, eh hindi po ito mababali. Amen? Once it comes out of His lips, it will come to pass. Do not steal from God. Return the tithes back to Him and give your love offerings. These are sacred to the Lord. It is sacred. And see how He will provide for you in ways that you cannot think of or imagine. If there's anything that we would like, that the Lord would like to remind us today, trust Him. Do not be tempted with an iPhone lying down, lying there. Do not be tempted with a wallet. No? A wallet that has slipped off a person's purse, pocket. Because if you open the back of the wallet, it is not a blessing from God. Because the name of that person is there. Do not be tempted. And do not be tempted to keep, not to give God, return God's tithes. It is sacred. Sabi mo nga, it is sacred. Alam niyo ba kung ano ibig sabihin ng sacred? Sobra. Para kang pumasok sa isang, ano, para pumasok ka sa isang simbahan na tahimik na tahimik. Kala mo, sacred. Wala ka may papakinggan. Bakit tayo namumulungan? Brad, sacred itong lugar. It is sacred about God. Amen. Our memory verse today, plant it in your heart. Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse that there may be food in my house. Test me on this, says the Lord Almighty. Malachi 3 verse 10. Can we all stand up? Let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for your word today. It's a lamp for me to preach this, but it has to be preached. To those who are affected, may they be affected positively, not negatively. Because this is your word, Lord God, not mine. To those who are still struggling, Lord God, to give their tithes and love offering, let your Holy Spirit empower them now. We cannot outgive God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord God. What more can we ask for, Lord, to prove your love for us? Money is nothing. If we die, we cannot bring anything with us.
Excuse me.
But you did not see our possessions. You see through our possessions. Through our possessions, you looked at our soul. You do not want our soul to die in hell, but you want us to be with you in heaven. That's why He gave the best gift for humanity. His Son Jesus, your Son Jesus, who died for us while we were still sinners. He gave up His life. As we partake of these elements now, so that we be reminded of God's love. This is not just a part of the program. Jesus Christ said, do this as often as you can so that you will not forget. This is not religion, my friends. This is reminding us that we are so important. Each one of us is important. No matter what you have done to your life, no matter what the world has done to you, this is, God is saying to us through this, you are important. You are the apple of my eyes. Father, we thank you, Lord God. Now as a church family, we will remember, Lord, with thanksgiving.